I'm honored and delighted to be sitting with Dr. Naresh Trehan, who is the Chairman and Managing Director for Medanta, the Medicity. He's a world-renowned cardiologist, cardiothoracic and cardiovascular surgeon. Thank you so much, Dr. Trehan, for speaking to Only My Health.
Thank you.
So, they call you the super surgeon. It's 50,000 open heart surgeries or more maybe now?
Yeah, I stopped counting many years ago, but that's okay. I mean, it's meaningless, the numbers are meaningless, but yes, I am a cardiac surgeon, yes.
Yes, yes, and a great one at that. So we're very happy to have you as an expert here because, you know, cardiovascular diseases and with the Lancet study right now, the deaths related to cardiovascular diseases in India and globally, we see that there is a exponential rise. Between 1990 to 2016, the numbers have almost doubled. What do you attribute this increase?
So, you know, there are several factors. Basically, there is one major identification that we do is basically because we are so mobile now. Mobility has increased all over the world. It was always there in the West, but in the rest of the world, people are now on the move all the time. They are leaving home to wherever your job takes you. You don't have time to go home to eat. So there is a lot of consumption of what we call junk food. It's food, but it may not be healthy, okay? So that is one, that our eating habits have become erratic. The other shift that has taken place is today, the level of stress, no matter what you do, has gone up exponentially. Then you're self-inflicted. Self-inflicted is alcohol, excess of alcohol. Smoking or tobacco in any form, in the smallest amount, is your enemy. Obesity is your enemy. Stress is your enemy. Now, stress you can control. Now, the way you control stress is that if you start doing the pranayama or vipassana in yoga, you can de-stress yourself every 24 hours. So if you de-stress yourself every 24 hours, you write off the stress of the last 24 hours and you can have a fresh day ahead of you.
Charge your batteries.
Yes. So now that's a very important thing because you can add on to it. You can entertain, movies, music, family life, friends. These are all stress busters, but you must do that so that you do not have accumulated stress, because accumulated stress will also give you high blood pressure, will give you spasm in your arteries, will damage you mentally and physically.
Okay, so these are the conditions, but are there any people who are specifically more at risk? Is anyone preconditioned to have a heart disease?
The factors that have been always around is genetics, which people are now beginning to recognize, but they've always been there. So we know that heart disease runs in families. And now we say, know your genes, because if your parent, one parent has heart disease, then the children will have twice the incidence. So you're saying, if the general population in India, around 10 to 12% will have heart disease, the children will have a 25% chance. Now that's 1 in 4 is a big chance. But in addition to that, there is a huge increase in the number of diabetics in countries like India. If you have diabetes, also diabetes contributes hugely to heart disease. Let us create, for a common understanding, a metabolic syndrome. So you have, if your blood sugar is high, your blood pressure is high, your cholesterol is high, and your waist is big, so we say 36 inches for men and 34 for women, these are all risk factors that form the triad. If you out of the five risk factors, and high blood pressure is the other, if you have three out of those five, then you're already at high risk.
So you're preconditioned to have a heart disease.
Yeah, you are. Your propensity to develop heart disease is more than your normal population. In addition, if you add on stress, bad food and smoking or tobacco in any form, then it is suicidal. Okay, then what do you do? So we say, one, incorporate exercise in your life on a regular basis. That means regular being 5 times a week at least. Consistent 30 minutes to 40 minutes of exercise will keep your cardiovascular system, that is by circulation and by mobilization of any bad toxins that are accumulating in your body. If you do it four or five times a week, you give yourself the best chance.
But a lot of people say that we have active lifestyles, we're always on the move, our work allows a lot of movement. Is that also equal to exercising?
See, people play golf. They think that that's exercise. That is partial exercise, because for every shot they hit, they walk, but then they stop. That continuous 30 minutes is what you need to know. Ah yeah, you want to play golf after that? Why don't we play golf? You want to go shopping after that? That's fine. But don't consider that or have that misconception that people say that, but it's all stop and go.
And that doesn't count.
Housework is work. It does consume calories, but it does not give you cardiovascular, and it does not consume that many calories because it's not continuous. The first 20 minutes of exercise, you are still in positive metabolic state. You want to get to catabolic state when the body starts consuming fat.
How important are health checkups, and how regularly should one get them done?
We classify people, and I'll address only the high-risk group. So the high-risk group is a group which has genetic history, that is disease in the family, diabetics, obesity, high cholesterol, smokers. So any of these four things will put you in the high risk group. Especially if your genetics acts early. Okay. So we say those people should be tested regularly by cardiovascular testing, which is two things. One is exercise test. The other is we have ways and means of finding out that their arteries are not getting stiff, because that's the first sign of disease in the arteries. So we have what we call carotid, we have brachioradial index, we have many things that's high risk group. By the age of 25, they should have had their first checkup. The second group is the group that does not have genetic history, does not have diabetes history in their family, but has very high cholesterol, obese, lazy lifestyle and all that. So that between 25 and 30, they must have their first checkup, because we should know where they are headed. In general public, we say by the age of 30, men and women should have had their first general checkup. The general checkup will be, we have the blood profile, we have the treadmill test, we may in some cases have to do an echo, abdominal ultrasound if there is any signs of it. But this checkup, which is not that expensive, is sub 2000, and you can actually be comfortable that you are as good as you can be at your age. And then depending on that, we prescribe how often do you want to do their checkups.
Doctor, tell me some of the red flags, the warning signs that come early on that are sometimes ignored, forgotten, taken as something else.
Your symptoms, shortness of breath and chest pain. Chest pain, usually consistent with walking, is exertional, but you can get it at any time. It can be nocturnal when you sleep. The biggest danger to humanity is the confusion between heartburn, acidity and chest pain from heart. So if you do get it and you have your own remedy, it used to be in the old days Amrit Dhara,
Jeera,
Pudin Hara, or antacid, you know, jo bhi kuch liya. But if it does not go away in the first 15-20 minutes, then you start thinking that it could be from the heart, and you must go and take the trouble of going to the nearest clinic, heart, hospital, whatever you can find, to get a cardiogram. And now there is a very efficient blood test, which is known as troponin. Troponin that can be done, and within 15 minutes you know whether you're getting any injury or not.
All right, doctor, I have a list of statements with me, and I would like you to separate the facts and the myths for us. So are you ready? Here we go. So the first statement is that heart disease is just for old people. I'm still young, I'm in my 30s and 40s, so I cannot have a heart disease. Fact or a myth?
So it's a misnomer to say, or a wrong belief to say, that because I'm 25, 30, I'm immune to heart disease. No. Especially if you have heart disease in the family and you're a smoker.
Okay, the second statement is that I would know if I was having a heart attack because I would have chest pains. Fact or myth?
That is not a fact. I mean, it's a negative thing you've asked, that it is a fact that you can get atypical chest pain.
Okay.
Atypical chest pain related to the same activity. Exercise, or when you're angry or whatever, and you get pain in the jaw or choking in the neck or even in the back of your head. They can all be symptoms of coronary artery disease, right? That's a very important thing to know. That if you think that no, it's nothing, it's here, it's not here. That's what I said, classical angina. These are atypical forms of angina. Going down the left arm is classical. Chest pain here, going down to the left arm, classical. Some people get just pain here, both sides. Some will say, my hands become very heavy. So there are many variations. But if it is happening, it's best to go and check with the doctor here. You get my point?
Absolutely. Because in popular media, you always shown heart attack, dil ka daura, you know, like that, and then you don't expect anything.
There's another myth which I want to say for protection of women who, you know, in the movies you used to see that somebody's daughter, she ran away with somebody and the father had a heart attack.
Yo, bhagi.
She didn't give him the heart attack. See, this is what I'm trying to say. You know, the old myths, I mean, say, usne aisa kiya, wo unki jaan le gayi. That's all nonsense.
You were leading up, your lifestyle was leading up to
that. Yeah, it was already there. There was one final event that had to happen.
Another one, doctor, that I cannot have heart problems because I have no symptoms. I know that you've answered that a lot.
No, I want to add to that. If you take today, there will be anywhere close to 20,000-25,000 people who will go to sleep in India tonight, happily playing with their children, grandchildren, eating, drinking, whatever they did, who will not wake up in the morning. They never had any idea they had heart disease. This can be a silent killer. So that is no comfort that you have no symptoms. That's why I said you should have regular checkups.
And the only way is regular checkups and knowing if you're preconditioned to. Yeah, okay, great. So her heart disease runs in my family, so I cannot do anything to prevent it.
Genetics is one risk factor. What other risk factors you add on to it, it multiplies.
Yes.
The more number of risk factors, the more the chances you'll get it. So you have in the family. Now you must control exercise, cholesterol, no smoking, very limited alcohol. And de-stressing. You can slow it down, you can prevent it, you can stop it. So don't get discouraged because your family genetics, but you be aware.
Doctor, what are the sort of lifestyle changes that somebody can make, the smaller changes that can attribute to a longer, healthier heart and life?
Lack of sleep is also related to heart disease. If you are chronically sleep deprived, that is another lifestyle problem. And when we were talking about the current generation where you get hooked onto your phone, those people are at risk again. Alright? Incorporating exercise in your life. Obesity is bad. So you want to stay within your advice, the weight, because there are charts available with age and your height will tell you your ideal body weight. Then you eat what you like, basically. But in moderation. So if you are going to get into a dilemma, there is a samosa sitting in front of you. If I eat it, I will die. If I don't eat it, I will live 5 minutes longer at the age of 90.
But I would have missed this samosa.
But this is instant gratification. Okay. So you had one samosa in a week or 3-4 days. Nothing bad. But does not say that there were four lying there, that I like one and then I'll go for the other. Okay, I have weakness for samosa, so I address samosa. So
so if the doctor can eat a samosa, we can, but yeah, in a balanced and responsible.
Everything is balanced. Yeah? See, the wahi main keh raha hoon ki you can, I said you can have a drink. Tobacco is the only thing I would say is absolutely, yeah.
So finally, Dr. Trehan, what is the one message that you would like to leave our viewers with ahead of Heart Day?
So message is, please don't get a heart attack on on World Heart Day. But I think that the things that I talked about, mantra is very simple. You're going to be exercising, you're going to be eating intelligently, you're going to be drinking intelligently, you're not going to be smoking, and you're going to bust your stress on a regular basis, and that's the best you can do for yourself. Then good luck, enjoy yourself.
Thank you so much, Dr. Trehan, for speaking to Only My Health. If you like that video, remember to share it. You can be saving lives, saving hearts. And do subscribe to Only My Health.